Ora si registrerà la conferenza.
Good morning, I'm Giovanni Ricevuti from the University of Pavia and I'm the local coordinator of IHOD project. Welcome to Pavia, University of Pavia and is very old and I, together with Michela Cobelli from administration and Ciro Esposito, professor of nephrology from our university, and also Professor Giambattista Parigi from pediatric surgeon of our university. We are working together to develop the project and the program of the project EHOD. Pavia is old university. We started in 1825 with Lotarius Edict, and then we became university in 1361 so it is 60 50 59 years ago. This is University of Pavia in the center of the town. Pavia is a classical typical Romanic town, as you can see from this picture. And we had a lot of important professors like Girolamo Scardanus, the inventor of card and joint, and also Alessandro Volta, the inventor of battery of Volta. This is the teaching room dedicated to Volta, and also, for example, Maria Pellegrini Amoretti, the first woman graduated in Italy in law, and then Camillo Golgi, Nobel Prize in Medicine. Our project, the EHOD, is very important because it's related to chronic disease, and chronic diseases is one of the most important topics of Europe because we have to teach something that is not normally taught at European universities. Chronic disease is a very big world of diseases, not only diseases, but also syndromes. And because a lot of conditions, pathology condition became chronic. And we have to define better to stress the topic of chronic diseases in about clinical aspects, social aspects, especially social aspects, organization of the services, the cost, the prevention, and also education of population and health workers in this aspect. So we organized two intensive weeks in Pavia, one for teachers of the universities involved in this project, and one for students enrolled in this project, using roundtables, lectures, teleconferences, multidisciplinary meetings with a lot of professors, specialists, visit to rehabilitation hospital, visit to International Oncological Center. We host now that is one of the three ADRO therapy center in the world, one in Italy, one in Germany, one in Japan. Meetings with general manager of public health system in Lombardy country. This is very important because Lombardy health system, regional system, is considered the most important, the most effective, the most active and appreciated health system in Italy, and also with international connection with professors coming from many countries of Europe. Our goal is to define better the method to teach and to define, to identify the best method to put at the center of the attention the doctor, the patient with chronic disease, and to change healthcare, the managing the healthcare, in particular the managing of patients with chronic diseases, and also to empower patients with education, health literacy for patients, in addition to preparation and education of social workers, doctors, nurses, psychologists, physiotherapists, and so on. This is very different from to educate patients and people, normal people, to automedication. We don't suggest to use this method that is very used into the European population. So with IHOD, we would like to stress, to contact, to sensibilize public and private stakeholders, and also give formation, education to elderly citizens, caregiver, general practitioners, geriatrician, researchers, epidemiologists, and to try to change the organization of national and regional health system, not only in Italy, not only in Europe, but also to build this new aspect in the countries of university partners. So with IHD and with the help of all actors of this activity, we hope to be able to disseminate our results. This is important for Europe because Europe is aged. The age of population is increasing respect to the last the two century the last century or the two last centuries. And aging population is increasing in number, but also in disability. 40% is what is living in long-term care, and 80% is not able to work, and also the ratio of workers to pensioners is very strange, is changing with increment of the number of pensioners and decreasing the number of workers. This is very important and need a revolution in organization of health system. Europe suggests that we have to change something in our organization because frail elderly people represent the 30% of all admission in the hospital, and they stay over 10 days for those over the age of 75. This is very big problem because we have this is stressing the health system, regional and national system, and because we evidenced that there is a no connection between acute and chronic system with hospital and country medicine. So Europe suggested that we need to prepare more doctors, nurses, and so on in acute, general, and geriatric medicine. So this means that we need to change, to remodel acute medicine, emergency departments, and also geriatric medicine. This means country medicine and therapy and coordination of the activities for elderly and patients with chronic diseases. So this means patients with disabilities. And this is a problem because until now, these two aspects, acute and chronic medicine, is not working together. In addition, we have another big problem in Europe and also in the world, because in care homes, a form of dementia, the patients with dementia represent two-thirds and one-quarter of hospital beds are occupied by people with dementia, and it is necessary to change the organization, especially in this period, in the time of coronavirus. Coronavirus changed the problems and the needs of population and the organization of the hospitals and country medicine. So, and also the observation, scientific observation, demonstrated that chronic patients at bottom or at risk for coronary COVID infection and in worsening their quality of life and have more difficulties accessing care and treatment. So we organized 2 weeks with these topics to discuss health education and promotion, leadership and management, research project, introduction to bioethics in public health, introduction to public health, global health and health informatics. This is important, global health. Coronavirus, COVID demonstrated that we are not ready. We are not prepared to organize and to observe corona global health. And also we discussed health policy, quality and health economics. So we have one teacher round tables in international teaching from professor from other countries, teleconferences and also on-site discussion until the last day with the satisfaction of all participants. With students enrolled in this project, we organized specific teaching and also clinical rotation in different departments. We discussed also how can we build the discover a new drug, the importance of herbal therapy and also of complementary medicine. And we offered the possibility to attend a course of BLSD using the defibrillator, giving the students an international recognized certificate. We stay with students all day, also to eat. We organize a visit to specialized department, and also we organize a role play and exercitation with an informatic mannequin. Electronic informatic mannequin, and they tried to face many diseases from coronary, heart, pulmonary, and so on. At the end of the week, we organized a final ceremony together with professors and students at an agritourism. Teaching, learning by doing, and teaching by eating. We stressed the problem of the students, the role of the students that will be the new actors. So we used the method also student as teacher, stimulating the students to prepare some lesson. This during the week and during this in particular ceremony. You can see it in picture, and this is the example of teaching.
Management of diabetes or control of diabetes, you can also think of those, and that maybe you can make the prices of wine much better and accessible. people just like hearing. They were scientific tools that were said. So I just brought them here.
And also singing. And also with teachers. And also at the end we gave the diplomas, the international diploma to the students.
Boys.
Okay, so we conclude our project with this sentence of Goethe. Knowing is not enough, we must apply. Willing is not enough, we must do. And this is what we are hoping to do. Thank you very much.